Hey everybody, it's Alex Fournier for alexfournierart.com and artistic purposes. Today we're going to be drawing some boots.
Alright, today we're using a compressed charcoal stick. This one is Generals 2B and I'm working on newsprint. A lot of the mark making techniques I use with a compressed charcoal stick are totally different than how you would write with a pencil. Okay, I'm going to be holding it sideways and I'm going to be dragging up to make lines. I'm going to set it down to make lines. I'm going to drag it. I'm going to turn it. Right? All kinds of different stuff. All right, let's draw some boots. All right, we're going to go real loose with this. Draw the one on the foot first. Okay, I'm kind of working with the contours here. Like I said, I'm working loose today. Okay, for the shoelaces, I'm just going to imply them. All right, so let's do some of these tones and highlights. Draw the kind of the shapes of where I'm going here. And if you found that you've kind of guessed wrong, you just fix it as you go. Okay, notice I'm building this up geometrically. Not tons of round shapes except for the contours. All right. Okay, let's get the shadow under the pants. Okay, I'm drawing the shape of it before I fill it in. Okay, we got the wrinkly pants. Okay, with the shoelaces, I'm gonna just imply some negative space here. And do some turning edge along the side. Okay, good enough. Let's move on. All right, let's do Let's do the back of some shoes here. I'm going to try to go smaller here. All right, let's get some of these wrinkled shaves from the leather. Once again, we'll do our negative space here to show the laces. A little shadow from the jeans. And we're kind of doing some speed drying right now, trying to keep from getting too distracted. Okay, and I'm leaving some room for the bounce kind of under here. And I'm going to do a little turning edge, give some three-dimensionality to the edge of the shoe. And okay, let me do a little kneaded eraser, get some of these shiny parts back. Okay, and be sure to check out the other episode about jeans. I want to get more in depth about doing these wrinkles. Okay, you see how I slide this around? Actually, this has got some fun wrinkles in the reference. Let's do the seam. Okay, we got our jeans there. All right, one other trick when you're drawing something that's flat on a surface. Let's pretend this is a wet surface. All right, good enough for now. Let's move on. What else we got? All right. Let's try these dress shoes. And I'm just trying to get the basic rhythms in here. Try to move back further since I don't want to cover my other drawing. Building up some core shadow here in different tones. It's technically some very reflective shapes in here because it is leather. Okay, so we're gonna build those shapes up. Okay, so we see some of that shininess coming through. Cases actually just playing off the lighting. Okay, and I'm just building up basically some shadows and highlights along this as a way to get some three-dimensionality. Hey, we've got the pants up here. Got some big wrinkles. All right, get a little edge light going there. Gonna do the turning edge on this side. Try to get some form around the side. Okay, we've got some pretty good reflections in here. Got some good highlights. All right, looking pretty good, right? All right, what else we got? All right, on this one, I'm gonna go super loose. Right, run it right off the page. Okay, and let's actually deal with what if the sock was a little wrinkly here. Some hairy legs. Little turning edge. Okay, we've got the grains of the sock. Okay. And going to try to get these wrinkles implied, but very loosely. Basically using the benefit of using charcoal for this kind of thing. You always want to think about the material you're using and maximize what that material is good for in terms of technique. Okay, so in terms of fabrics and leather and wrinkles, compressed charcoal is great for those things. And so it's definitely good to have fun maximizing what the tool is good for. Okay. We're getting all the way down to the edge of the page here. Let's jump back to this other reference and do the other foot. Here we go. All right, I'm cheating a little on the location of this versus this just because I kind of running out of room and the proportion isn't quite right. But we're still drawing boots. Okay, you see how I'm using negative space to show the laces. All right, and let's work on these shadows. What's interesting some of the time is to think about, can you communicate the shadows without coloring everything in, right? Can you leave something for the viewer to fill in? And that's maybe, could I leave that empty? Yeah, I think so. Okay. Okay, got some wrinkles up there. Okay, not too bad. Let's try to get this bottom part to look more like a highlight. A lot of times with leather, there's these different planes that are catching different kinds of light. And so a lot of the shininess can be done by creating these little shadow shapes that have complete borders, right? They don't just kind of fade. Okay, nice and shiny. All right, can we fit anything else on this page? Can we squeeze anything else? All right, can I go back to this reference? Super small. Okay, and you notice all these different geometric shapes I'm doing in the bottom. A lot of times there's all these different reflective surfaces, especially on leather, and some of that gets communicated in the form of these little geometric little patterns. Okay, so we got some, let's get a turning edge here. Okay. get a little three-dimensionality. Okay, what do we got here? I'm going to make use of every part of this page. This is the last page on Earth. Okay, you see these shapes? We're trying to apply some reflective wrinkles of leather. All right, is there anything else we can fit on this page? Anything up here, maybe? Let's maybe just draw this guy up there. Thank you. guy's kind of fun. Alrighty, a page full of boots plus a little bonus character on the side. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next time.